Hi guys. This video is the third in a video series that introduces how to make a desktop 5-axis CNC machine. This time, we will assemble and adjust the X-axis and Y-axis linear guides and ball screws. I will do my best to show you the most accurate adjustments possible. Also, I will introduce the new friends I ordered. It is CNC 1310. It's like a home-use CNC mill that can process metal. The reason I bought this machine is that my 5-axis CNC is now disassembled, and I don't have a machine that can process it when I want to process something. I'm thinking of making another video about this machine, so please watch it if you are interested. The reason why I show this machine now is that it is easy to explain the difference in structure between household CNC machine and industrial CNC machine. My 5-axis CNC machine aims to build a machine with the same performance as an industrial 5-axis CNC machine on a desk. So far, it doesn't have that much performance. But I used parts that are as close to industrial machines as possible. These are the topics in this video. If you watch this video, you can see why most household CNC can't cut metal that is harder than aluminum. In this series, I also want to show you useful information for building your own CNC machine. Also, my machine is basically my hobby, and I enjoy it on my free time nights. I hope everyone can enjoy making machines as well. If you are watching a video on this channel for the first time, after watching this video, think about whether the video on this channel is useful to you. After that, it is recommended to subscribe to the channel. The ball bearings of liner guide are usually sitting in an R or V-shaped groove instead of using a plain contact, from which some manufacturers are claiming 13 times as much load capacity. Linear guides are also extremely accurate, errors are usually measured in the micrometers range. The addition of a preload into the guide can also increase accuracy and repeatability. Instead of having a small clearance between the track and the ball bearings, an interference fit is used. Liner shafts must be sized to support the load within an acceptable deflection tolerance. Too much weight and the shafts will bend, causing a positioning error. The bushing to shaft interface is also relatively loose, which can cause issues with accuracy and repeatability. Let's start assembling and drinking. Have a good time. Advantages of ball screws. Highly efficient, requiring less torque, therefore smaller motor. Higher accuracy grades for greater positional accuracy. Lower friction, able to run at cooler temperatures. Available in rolled and ground types. Can be adjusted to increase slash decrease preload. Need to be replaced less frequently. When working with metals that are harder than aluminum, it is important that they are strong enough to withstand the high cutting resistance during machining. By using preloaded ball screws, you can maintain a tough state without rattling. Try disassembling the ball screw housing. Preload is applied by combining the two bearings to hold the ball screw and eliminate rattling. I also want to disassemble and show you the inside ball screw nut, but if disassemble it, the balls inside will fall and I will not be able to assemble it, so if you are interested, please Google it. Advantages of lead screws. Competitively priced. Self-locking, do not require a braking system. Well suited to vertical applications. Flexible configuration. Less noisy compared to ball screws. Lead screws are used in household machines. This machine uses two nuts and preloaded with the force of a spring. However, when processing a metal that is harder than aluminum, it will not be able to withstand the large cutting resistance, and it will be almost meaningless. If a strong spring that can withstand cutting resistance is used, this problem will be solved, but the resistance between the nut and lead screw will increase, so it will be necessary to use a higher torque motor. This time, I introduced a little about the difference between household machines and industrial machines. In conclusion, if you want to process something harder than aluminum, I recommend using a full metal frame, preloaded linear guides and ball screws. But, using those parts increases the cost. Another important thing is the spindle, which I will introduce in the next video. How was it? Did you enjoy? You watched this video to the end, so I think you enjoy this video. I recommend you to subscribe to this channel, so you don't miss the next video. Also, if you are interested in the 5-axis CNC machine I made, you can find it in the link of the related video in the remarks column. See you again.